Hello everyone and welcome to the greatest award show in the world. Now, it's the Westy TV Awards 2022 and to this year we have opened up 11 incredible awards for you to vote on. And tonight it's results night, basically. Basically we're going to award some incredible awards. For example, Music Artist of the Year, Film of the Year, Event of the Year, FBC Player of the Year, the Golden Ball of course is going to be given out as well this year. But we're also going to be presenting two extra awards tonight. The Westy TV Hero Heroine of the Year Award, bringing it back from 2020 when we gave it to the NHS for doing absolutely incredible work. And the Westy TV Legends Award, inducting someone or something into the Hall of Fame of Westy TV to be remembered forever and ever. So, first of all, I must thank you. It's been an incredibly long year of fun, stupidity, charitable, random stuff and events that I've been able to have the privilege of working on. And it's all made possible because of you guys at home, being sat on your chairs and drinking beer and or Coke or whatever you're doing right now. But thank you all very much. It's been an absolute pleasure to make content or help run events for you guys this year. I want to do it again in 2023. And it's looking even more exciting next year, so I can't wait. And also thank you to everyone who voted on the event. This year we also had a tripled the figure that we had in 2021 and 2020 on these responses. It's been absolutely incredible. I've never expected such a good response on these awards. We had 65 total responses to everything on these awards this year. And as much as some of you may have missed out awards or not voted on certain awards, that's completely fine, so don't worry. But thank you all very, very much for voting. And I need to get some jacket on that I think would be good for presenting this in. Yes, red jacket time. I said I'd never wear this again after Fight Night, and then I said I'd never wear it again after Halloween, and I'm back again. Less alcohol stained than it was. But right, let's get on with the awards. Now it is time for Music Artist of the Year. Now the nominees this year, we had 8 of them. We had Harry Styles, Taylor Swift, The Weeknd, One Republic, Imagine Dragons, Drake, and Kendrick Lamar and Adele. But we can only have one winner. Now, some of these were, and you must also mention, I'll mention it in a sec. But we can only have one winner. So, with 26.3% of the vote, we have a draw. Now, some of these votes have gone to draws, and I must say, the public is split opinion. Whatever you guys want to vote on, that's perfectly fine by me. I put these awards out for you guys to have a bit of a laugh. But with 26.3% of the votes and 15 votes each, your Westy TV Music Artists of the Year are Harry Styles and The Weeknd. So congratulations to them both. I'm sure we'll be able to get them their awards in time if they're not touring. But we'll see. Might have given one of them their awards in July, but we'll see. Right then, it's Content Creator of the Year. 3 nominees for this one, 2 YouTubers and 1 TikToker. Mr. Beast, The Sidemen, and Carby Lame. I'm sorry, Carby, I mispronounced your name. But with 36 votes, so a total of 65.5% of the vote, this year your Westy TV Content Creator of the Year is The Sidemen. Incredible work from the group this year, the 7 of them. Absolutely fantastic stuff. Looking forward to seeing what they do next year. Charity match as well. I think we should get invited to a charity match next year. Right then, it's now time for Westy TV Film of the Year. So some of you all went to the cinema this year. It's the first time I've properly been back for a whole year of cinema season. But we have six nominees: Top Gun Maverick, Minions, The Rise of Gru, The Batman, Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, Bullet Train, and Black Panther Wakanda Forever. But there were a total of 56 responses to this one, and with 25% of your votes, and with 14 total votes, your Westy TV Film of the Year is Top Gun Maverick. So, congratulations. Tom Cruise is the only actor of the nominees tonight to receive a Westy TV Award. Westy TV Sporting Moment of the Year. Now, there were lots of sporting moments of 2022, but we had to narrow it down to five very, very specific and important ones. But the five nominees this year: Bucks New University defending their Varsity title against Roehampton. What an incredible night that was. Morocco becoming the first African team to reach the semi-finals of a World Cup. The 2022 Formula One British Grand Prix. Rangers reaching the UEFA Europa League final. And England women winning the UEFA European Championships. And your Westy TV Sporting Moment of the Year with 48.2% of the vote, with 27 votes, is Morocco becoming the first African team to reach the semi-finals of a FIFA World Cup. Congratulations, Morocco. Incredible stuff from them. Right, moving on to Westy TV Event of the Year. Now, there was only one vote in this one, so only 2%. But Westy TV Event of the Year, the nominees are B&U Boxing's Fight Night in 2022, back in May, the FBC Champions League Finals, the charity one that we raised about £125 something for, but I've still got to do the challenges for. We'll get those done soon, I promise. The Buxton University versus Roehampton University Varsity 2022 are your three nominees. But with 41.4% of the vote and 24 of your votes, it is the FBC Champions League Finals 2022 for Mind. But thank you all very, very much for your votes there. That's incredible. And also thank you very much for your donations back in April, May time. It was an incredible event to do. I wish we did a charity fundraiser for the World Cup this year. So I had a feeling I wanted to do something for Amnesty International, but we've not. I didn't put something on in the end, and I think it was just more a time thing. Right, Westy TV Team of the Year. Now, we have five nominees for this one. The Bucks FC Ones, the University League title winners. England Women, the UEFA European Championships. Real Madrid, the UEFA Champions League winners. And John Ward's Warriors, the FBC Champions League winners, And then the United States of America, the FBC Nations League winners. So with 27.6% of the vote, and with 16 votes, with one vote in it between the top two, it's the Westy TV Team of the Year is England Women for winning the UEFA European Championships. Bucks FC Ones were one vote behind, so I'm sorry, Lance, about that one. But hey, Westy TV Pundit of the Year now. We've got five nominees for this one. These were all visitors on Westy TV this year on any form of media. And these are all notable and the people you really, really liked. So we had Francois Collus, Sean Worrell, Owen Taylor, Joshua Fake, and Kai Howell. But with 36.5% of the vote, he's done it for 3 years in a row. It's Owen Taylor is your Westy TV Pundit of the Year. And he was back this evening for the FBC World Cup. I hope you all enjoyed him. He's an incredible character. Right, now the fun one that you all really, really enjoyed. Westy TV Worst Elliot Photo of the Year. Now, I've been caught in some very interesting situations on camera this year. Thankfully, I've not been cancelled yet. But it's time to reveal the nominees for this one. And I'm going to put them up on the screen as well so you can all see them. Elliot running into a fence at Varsity during the hockey game. Movember charity waxing, where somehow Elliot's legs raised £50 of the total. Elliot doesn't remember this night or what happened, what he was doing in the photo. Elliot traumatising everyone at Bingo Lingo. Referee Elliot out in force, my yellow and red cards. Gerard Piquet pulled off the football net carrying, Elliot didn't. Blinding lights, and I just put Festival 2023, set anyone? Maybe. I don't think it's going to happen, guys. I'm really sorry. With 31.6% of the vote, your worst Elliot photo of the year is referee Elliot out in force. And to be honest, I'm quite shocked and surprised by this one, because I thought it was been running into a fence at Varsity during the hockey game, because everyone seemed to love that. But hey-ho. It's incredible. But thank you very much for your votes on that one. I will frame it and put it up somewhere. Right, the next award, the Golden Cock Award. Now, this isn't measuring or doing anything with people's things. It's just the biggest moron or words we can't say on Western TV. But there were 6 nominees for this one. And my God, these were shocking. There was a lot of shocking this year. There was one that someone said I should have put on, that was Will Smith. And I really wish I did put it on there, because that would be hilarious, because Will Smith is a massive one, a golden massive cock. But Boris Johnson with Partygate is your first nominee. Liz Truss resigning after 49 days as Prime Minister. The letters lasted longer. Elliot West for multiple awful karaoke appearances. Elon Musk for ruining Twitter. Cristiano Ronaldo for his Piers Morgan interview. And also Piers Morgan lipsing him repeatedly on Twitter. Vladimir Putin and Russia invading Ukraine. So with 27.3% of the vote, and this was 2 votes ahead of the next one, but your Golden Cock Award winner this year is Elliot West for multiple awful karaoke appearances. Right, hold it just a second. I'm going to put a bet out there. If this video or the FBC World Cup 2022 final video gets to 100 likes, either one of these videos, I will release the karaoke from the Halloween takeover that I did. And it was a certain weekend song. And it's 4 minutes long, so I'll upload the entire thing to YouTube. That is a bet. So 100 likes on this video or the FBC World Cup video. You know what you're going to do. It's in your hands. And the FBC Player of the Year Award. Now, this is a very prestigious award for FBC players. It's one of the main ones that everyone absolutely loves. But this year, it's a standout player on the FBC server that everyone really, really likes and enjoyed. But your nominees this year are Emerg, Trickshot, Cappage, Orky, Robbe, Joker, Mercy, Rogers, Mr. Rogers, Hidan and El Trilarco. But some incredible players on there, but there could be one winner. Your FBC Player of the Year with 32.7% of the vote is Mr. Rogers. And he's absolutely dethroned Trickshot of his tie this year. He was second best in this vote. But Mr. Rogers, congratulations, you are FBC Player of the Year. We'll get your golden ball shipped to you. But congratulations, Rogers, legend. Now it's time for the People's Awards. So I asked you guys to send in some incredible stories or some, just say, why do you want to give people awards? So tell us who and a reason why. So, the first one is just Carlos Barra. So we're not off to a great start. The second one is Robbe for being such a great individual. I agree. I'm not being paid to say it, I promise. Daniel Baker for Biggest Nonce Award. Keep him inside. Dave, because he's just, well, Dave. I think that's Dave the Cat. Mr. Rogers, he's my idol. Well, he's already got 2 awards tonight. He's got another one there for the People's Award. DK for being the GOAT. No, Messi's the GOAT. DK is him. Elliot West for his consistency. Where have I been consistent? Is it consistently shit or just consistently okay? I would like to give the People's Award to Pablo 1325 for his contributions to racial inclusivity and equality. In the past, Pablo was rather racist, seen in many screenshots, but he has turned a new leaf and now fights for the equality of all. Thanks, Pablo. I'm glad you've turned a new leaf, because it's quite concerning, but, you know, I'm glad you've turned a new leaf. The Shitpost Award. It's an award. Nothing special, but it's dedicated to my reformed Orthodox rabbi, Bill Clinton. Okay, Owen, because he loves a kebab. He does love a kebab. He loves kebabs. What a man. Guy Howell for walking you to work when it was icy. Okay, we did it slippy that day, but, you know, I wasn't trusted. Elliot West having to listen to It's Coming Home after being knocked out of the World Cup at work. This was the morning after, this was about 2 days after the World Cup game between England and France. Some dickhead decided to play It's Coming Home on the playlist of thing at my work. I just wanted to say, if I ever find you, and I know it's you, I will kill you. One just said, shut up, you non-Western TV word. Mr. Rogers, the GOAT. Rogers, because I love it. Rogers, I think you're winning the People's Award here. Putin, I think it's just an augur. Oh, maybe not, actually. GOAT. GOAT Miage, GOAT. No one, that's fine. You can do that one. Obama's wife, because he's goated. This is not written by Obama's wife. I think it is written by Obama's wife. Someone just said, Wes, I think you deserve the best YouTube reward. I don't, because it went to the Sidemen. Because something, simply nothing as good as Westy is good. Nothing is as good as Westy TV. Elliot's best arse ever. Oh shit. No, I disagree.
Yeah.
The biggest hug merchant, Ethan Hutchison. Ethan does love a cuddle. He loves a cuddle. And Charlotte for being a great SGU president. I completely agree with that last one. But thank you very much for submitting your People's Awards. I'm quite impressed, quite intrigued. Knock this back a second. We're very intrigued to see what you all sent in for the Western TV Awards this year for the People's Award. But thank you very much. Now it's time for two awards that you couldn't vote on. So this is the Western TV Hero Heroine of the Year Award. Someone who's gone above and beyond to contribute to society in 2022. So in 2020 it was the NHS, and we didn't have a vote on this in 2021. I don't know why we didn't, to be fair. It was quite a few hero heroines. Oh, actually, with my therapist. Sorry, my counsellor and therapist that year. But this year it's been brought back to commemorate or acknowledge a comedian turned leader, which is a bit odd, it's a bit odd out of context, but you know. So we would like to award at Westy TV the Hero Heroine Award to Volodymyr Zelensky of Ukraine. So congratulations, Volodymyr. It's absolutely, you've done an incredible job defending Ukraine, and we continue to support you and Volodymyr Zelensky. Right, and now for my last award, and some of you might be, well, it's quite sad by this one. I probably should take my jacket off because it's not really, so this isn't really a colourful story. Right, well, this is the Western TV Legends Award. Now, the Legends Award is usually commemorated to inaugurate someone into the Hall of Fame, or the Western TV Hall of Fame. I brought this in just for this year, because I wanted to, or just, I brought it into this year's kind of, this year's scope. Back in 2020, when I set up this channel, I had a dog named Dylan, and he was, he was part of the family for about 13 years, and he was an absolutely incredible dog. During the pandemic, when I set up Westy TV, he used to come upstairs quite a bit, and he'd go and sit in the room behind the camera, so the one there, and I'd be here commentating, streaming, chatting, doing this bit, and you know, sometimes I'd go in there and just go, have a hug with Dylan. It'd be a bit of a nice kind of, you know, post commentary, what's the word, a kind of post commentary, just that time out in a way. And Dylan was that kind of little thing for me. But while I was recording and making these sorts of videos for you guys, he was always there. And this is the first video I'm making in this house, back home from coming home from uni, where he's not actually here. And it's really, really heartbreaking thing for me. And I did want him to feature on a video early this year, or I was hoping he'd be here for this year's awards, but sadly he's not. Because he sadly passed away in August, but I'm here today putting him as the Legend of War, because he has been throughout my majority of my life. And I still want him to be part of this, this memory before I go. When Western TV ends, I still want this to be, remembered as a part of my life that I shared with Dylan. So, and as I said, I wanted to feature him on this year's awards. Unfortunately, we didn't get the opportunity to do so. But a lot of you may have noticed I do make quite a few jokes away from the public eye. I'm in private, I do make quite a few jokes to try and like help cope myself with the pain, but it's a bit hard, unfortunately. But so to keep his memory alive, I'm basically inducting Dylan into the Western TV Hall of Fame. He's the first inductee. There will be many, many more opportunities for the Western TV Hall of Fame to increase and grow over the next few years. But I'm trying not to cry. I'm trying to do my best not to cry and to get a bunged up nose at the same time, because I'll be absolutely in tears after this when I turn the camera off. But I really want to say as well, thank you to everyone who did send in messages. If you did hear about Dylan, I really did appreciate it. Whatever little message it was, I really did appreciate, any little thing, because he made a difference to so many other people's lives. And, it's one of those things for me which I want to try and remember him as much as I can. So, there we are. Dylan's our first inductee into the Western TV Hall of Fame, and he's our Legends Award this year. So, but that's the awards for this year. I'm going to move on and end on a high note so you guys can go off and enjoy your evening, your Friday nights. But I want to say a huge, huge thank you to everyone who voted on this year's awards. You've been absolutely fantastic this year. I'm really looking forward to 2023. As you can tell, my voice has gone a bit nasally and gone a bit off. I have been having trouble and having a bad cold the past couple of days. So do forgive me on this. But yeah, that is the Westy TV Awards 2022. Thank you all very, very much for watching. I'll see you in 2023. And goodbye.